All right, this entire interview will be conducted in Icelandic, except it won't be. Robinson Family is back, second season of Netflix sci-fi hit Lost in Space. Here comes Penny, Mina Sundwall. Nice to have you here.
Nice to be
here. Okay, you just got back from Reykjavik.
Yeah,
and boy, are your arms tired.
A couple months ago,
okay.
Yeah.
And how was it everything? Because we all want to go to Iceland immediately. Yeah.
It was amazing. It's the place that I say feels the most like what the Robinsons in the show are experiencing, because it looks like an alien planet. It's
wow.
These massive black sand beaches and this hardened lava all over the place. It's amazing.
Wow. And now people say it is the best looking species of people in the world. Is that true?
You know, I wouldn't disagree.
Okay. Wow. And then does it seem, so in terms of the topography, it seems foreign.
Yes.
Does it seem foreign as you're in a hotel or going to a restaurant or?
Well, I mean, no, but in terms of as soon as you step out of the hotel, there are very few people in Iceland, and so everything is spread out and quite isolated. So you can go to a hotel and then drive 45 minutes to a restaurant or to the center of
right.
the town. And then everything in between point A and point B is just completely alien world.
Wow.
Yeah.
This totally relates to Lost in Space.
It's very fitting.
People enjoyed the first season. Tell us about the second season.
The second season, which drops at midnight,
okay.
which is very exciting.
What are you doing at midnight?
I'm immediately refreshing my Netflix page and going to watch the first couple episodes.
All right.
We start the season 7 months off of after where last season ended. And in this time, the Robinsons were making do on this alien, toxic methane gas water planet.
Sure.
And so we see them become a bit of a family, because not every day was not life or death. And the kids have grown up a bit, both because of and in spite of the necessary fight for survival. And we are following them on their journey to reach the Resolute again and find everybody else.
Okay. There's, you know, obviously fantastic special effects, but it's really described as a family drama.
Mm-hmm. It is. It is. It's a show set in space, but it is about a family, and they're very real people with flaws, and the family definitely has their ups and downs.
Not only Iceland. Oh gosh, nothing. You went to the NASA Goddard Flight Center.
Yeah.
Ooh. How was that?
Ooh. It was incredible.
Look at you.
There I am. we were able to have a tour of the Goddard Center and see how they prep some of the craft that's going out into space. And so we saw the robots that will go into space and fix the satellites when something is wrong, or they have these platforms that spaceships will go on so you can test the vibration of a launch, or these rooms where you can test the sound to make sure that everything will hold. It was very interesting.
All right, the acting career is going very well, but
Thank you.
Think you want to become an astronaut.
I wouldn't be mad about it, yeah.
All right. Fair enough. Let me ask you this, because I think, and you know, this is becoming fewer and fewer the case, traditional broadcast television,
mm-hmm.
I would say, and the new season premieres, you know, February 1st, blah, blah, blah,
mm-hmm.
and then they roll out. But this, where they're all going to come out tonight mm-hmm. at midnight.
Yeah.
Do you like that better?
There's a part of me that likes it because I can be, you know, I like to eat everything at once. But I also like the idea of, because it's such a family show, you get to sit down and watch it with your family. So if you want to watch multiple episodes and spend a lot of quality time with your family and see it together, that's really sweet. If you want to space it out and see one this week, one next week, two in a couple weeks, it gives you freedom to plan out how, like, when you want to spend time and when you want to watch it. It's flexible.
You're 18.
I am 18.
Nice. The most poised 18-year-old we've ever had. Season 2 of Lost in Space drops on Netflix. Mina's watching tonight, and you can too, December 24th at midnight. Nice to see you this morning.
Nice
Thanks
to
so
see
much.
You. Thank you so much. Thank you.